Okay, everybody, Jerry here. I want to do a quick video on the ID5100, DStar radio, of course. And I have had to learn a couple things, and I just kind of felt that doing a video will definitely help kind of clear some of that up. So I'm going to show you how to do the local CQ and kind of what that means. I'm going to show you how to do call sign routing and some of the pros and cons of that. And then also linking up to a reflector and linking up to a different machine in another area, and kind of what that gateway means too, because that gateway is going to tie into the next video that I'm going to do about DPRS and the APRS overlay. So let's get this thing started right now. Okay, so if you look at the front of the radio, one of the things you notice right away is you got a from and you got a to. So from is your local access machine, or basically the one that you can hit near where you're at. So the two is, if I want to connect this to a reflector, San Diego Peak, which is close to me, then I can do that. If I want to just talk to the people on San Diego Peak, like a local, just regular repeater, then I can do that if it's on CQ. So then I would just key down like normal, KG6H QD on frequency. And I would just do that. Now you hear all these beeps. And one of the things, you see a UR question mark right there? That tells you that you made contact with that machine. So I know I'm getting in that machine. So let me show you something else on this, is the CS, Callsign. This is information that you need to know, because this is the gateway stuff. So obviously my call sign is that right there with the 5100. The R2 is not used. I'm gonna talk about that later, because you'll see G there. And this is the San Diego Peak machine that I'm going into with the B. The B indicates that it is a UHF machine, A being the 2 meter and so on. So the CQ. So you can see this information right here tells you that I am not connected to a gateway. I'm not connected to the internet is what a gateway means. This little thing right here is just like return back to zero. So now if I want to just connect it to something, I would just push two, and then I have options right here. I've already done it before. I can go into my transmit history. If I've heard a station, I can go into the receive history. But let's just pretend that we've never done anything. I want to go to a gateway CQ, because that's how I'm going to find a machine. This is the preloaded list in the 5100. You can see all the different countries and continents. And you hear things about code plugs, and code plugs will fix a lot of these different areas that you may want. But I know that Tony, K9ARV, my buddy over there in Florida, will be in the southeast. And you can see, because I've talked on it before, you can see where it's scrolled. That's why it's here. Otherwise, it would start at the top and be alphabetically down by state and by city. So I'm going to connect to the B machine. Now, just because I did that, that does not mean I'm connected. Look in call sign. See, it shows it's ready to roll, but you need to actually connect it by actually keying down the mic. Key down the mic. Now, basically, I told San Diego Peak, hey, connect to Tampa, the UR question mark, it's there. So let's see if Tony's on yet. K9ARV, KG6HQD, Tony, do you copy? While we're waiting for that, I'm going to talk about call sign routing. And what call sign routing is if I didn't know that Tony was on this Tampa machine, I would just basically hit this, and I could go transmit history, I'm sorry, receive history, or wherever Tony's call sign's at. I hit his call sign. Now, what I'm basically telling it is, when you key down on a gateway machine, it's logging your call sign onto whatever repeater you're on. So if I was on different repeaters, my call sign, it'll show the last one that I'm on. When it's set up like this, I could simply just key down like that, and let's say Tony wasn't on that Tampa machine. Let's say he's on a different machine. I would just key down like so. But I wanna listen, that's kind of the downside, and I'll talk about that in a minute. K9ARV, KG6HQD, Tony, do you copy? Now, I told him a quarter after, and you can see the clock there, it's 13:09, so I'm a little premature. But so that is how I would connect for call sign routing. Now, the big thing to look at is that you see the G here now. See the G? The G is the gateway. When they're talking about the eighth place, they're talking about that character right there. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, space.
K9ARV mobile. Oh,
there he is. Let's go back.
How are you, Jerry?
K9ARV, KG6HQD. All right. Video is running. I did call sign routing, and it found you on, I imagine, the Tampa machine, correct?
That's an affirmative. I'm on the W4RNT machine here in Tampa, Florida.
Okay, since he's on that Tampa machine, I'm going to back out of K9ARV and go directly to that. Okay, I'm going to take it out of the call sign routing. I mean, we're already monitoring this, and that way I can just go directly into Tampa. So, I know I found Tony on Tampa, but now I just want to do gateway machine, southeast, and I'm just going to go directly into Tampa. That's the machine that he's talking on. So I'm saying, hey, San Diego Pete, connect to Tampa, and let me talk to Tony. K9 ARV, KG6 HQD.
Okay, now you're straight into the Tampa machine now, Jerry.
Yep, that's directly into Tampa.
I hear you loud and clear. You're sounding perfectly clear here.
On this side, full quality, full signal strength, a great to and from for a digital. All right, Tony, thanks for the QSO, and I'm going to go ahead and stand by for a few minutes and wrap up what I'm doing on this end of the video.
DStar works great, guys. DStar works great. Two thumbs up.
All right, so you see when Tony talks,
his
call sign pops up here. As long as you want to, you also want to give a little space in between. You cannot really quick key on this. It'll create all kinds of problems. But if I didn't know, I could push RXCS, his receive call sign, and boom, I can lock him in. And I can scroll through and I can see all the different people that I've talked to, and I can lock them if I want to do a call sign routing. So there's a lot of advantages to understanding who you're talking to and where they're at and how to find them on digital. This is why I'm not an HF mobile kind of guy. You don't need to. With technology like this, you're able to do the same exact thing. So that kind of shows you where it's at. Now, I don't want to leave this connected. If I am done with my QSO with Tony, it's not polite to leave San Diego linked to Tampa. I need to unlink that. To unlink that, I go back there, and then I'm just going to hit local CQ, 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 KG6 HQD, systems unlinked. Thank you, guys. And, you know, and you notice that I said thank you, because before I started this video, I made an announcement that I wanted to link the machine to make sure that it wasn't somebody else out there that already had it linked or had a schedule with somebody. So it's just a polite thing to do is key down, announce your call sign, announce your intentions. Hey, I'd like to link this to the Tampa machine. Is there any objections? And let it rip. Now you can see that I'm all back here and the gateway is closed. So this thing, as far as my radio is concerned, is no longer linked to the internet. So that's it in a nutshell on linking to a machine and using call sign routing. Okay, so I just showed you how to do the call sign routing, and I showed you how to link to a local machine. And now what I want to show you is how to hook up to a reflector and how you would go back and forth between a reflector to link and unlink and use. Because there are a couple specific steps with reflectors on how you want to do it. You can do a direct entry. You can look in your receiver transmit history. There's things that you can do to do that. And that's all gateway. So I'm going to show you that real quick. All right. So we're back on the front of the machine. I had to turn the air on just a little bit. It's blazing hot here. I mean, you can see here that warm. Look, 92 outside. Ah, crazy. All right. Back to this. So now we're going to do hooking to a reflector. So what I want to do, let me see if I can get Tony to go to the reflector first. So see how fast this can go? Southeast, I know he's on Tampa. Now I can talk to Tony. Tony just stayed on Tampa for me. K9 ARV KG6 HQD. He might already backed out.
Very Jerry.
There he is. Hey, I want to show how to link to a reflector. You want to go to, say, 30 Alpha. Would that work?
All right, let me see if I could switch it to, I never did try a reflector, but I'll try it now.
See, this is why I'm making the videos. Actually, put that on the radio. So this is exactly why I'm making the videos, just to show those steps. So it's the same thing, but instead of going, you'll say from Tampa, and then in the two field, you're going to go into reflector, use reflector, then let's pick one. Let's just do 12 Alpha. Let's see if it's clear there. And then I'll find you on 12 Alpha. QSL?
Okay, QSL. I'll try to connect it to 12 Alpha.
All right, I'll see you over there, KG6 HQD. I'll be unlinking this and connecting to 12 Alpha for a demo, KG6 HQD. All right, so notice I made an announcement again. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to Tampa. I'm going to just kind of make sure that I'm disconnected. Just all you do is kind of kerchunk it. That disconnects it. Verify that. We're out. Nothing unused. So now what we want to do is in CQCQ, we're just going to go down here to Reflector. Now, link to Reflector. Boom. Now you can see here that I've already used it, so I can just punch it up and go, or direct input, I can do 12 and then change this to alpha, just up and down 12 alpha, and then hit set. That's another way to do it. So if somebody tells you and you don't already have it in your memory of used things, you can do it that way.
K9BRV.
Uh-oh, what'd Tony do? So then I just go to 12 alpha, link. Now notice it says link to reflector, so just kerchunk it. It's gonna come back with the UR call sign. It should. It should even say linked, actually.
Link currently established.
There you go. So link is established. Now I go to link reflector.
Hit Kilo Reflector. 9 Alpha Romeo Victor, K9 ARV.
And then use Reflector. K9 ARV, KG6 HQD on 12 Alpha.
Hey, Jerry, it's working. I guess I can link to Reflectors now. I'm on 12 Alpha as well.
Yep, worked pretty smooth. I got to do a video showing how that was done and a couple other things with it. So thanks for coming over here for the demo.
Be good, Jerry. 73s, and you're coming in full quieting here in Tampa, Florida.
Likewise, Tony, here in Corona, California, Southern California. Yeah, good copy. So this makes the need for HF mobile a little bit less reduced for me, for sure. No more antennas. All right, man. I'll hit you on Twitter later on for maybe a HF QSO once I get that set up in the backyard. 73, Tony. Thanks again, buddy. KG6 HQD.
Okay, Jerry. Not a problem. 73.
All right. So now that I'm done with that QSO, I want to go to link Reflector again. Now I want to unlink it. And all you do is you just kerchunk it and let it unlink.
Remote system unlinked.
Now we can verify that, hit call sign. It still shows that we're in the gateway, but we can just simply go local CQ, kerchunk it. And now we're back.
Not currently linked.
Now you hear that, it said not currently linked because I took it out of link and we're done, we're not linked. So we're not occupying the internet with this machine anymore. We took that offline to give it back to all the users so they can do exactly what I did. So it is one of those kind of things where you have to share it and kind of coordinate a little in advance. So that's it in a nutshell on how to link and unlink to a gateway, to a reflector, how to go into the local side. If you're in CQ, just remember that means you're basically using that digital repeater just as a normal repeater in your local area to the coverage that it's in, unless somebody has already established a link. So if somebody, like I had that linked up, and somebody extra came into the QSO, they're in the mix with whatever else that I've got linked up, per se. So you gotta keep that in mind. That's why it's important to unlink it so that you don't start jamming up all the links with the different digital repeaters. So that's it in a nutshell on how to do those links. I hope this video helped you out. Do me a favor, subscribe, hit the bell, do all that fun stuff, and find me on Twitter. I'm always active on Twitter. DM me on Twitter, that's always good. Instagram, I play on there too. Facebook's my personal stuff, of course. But I am on some Facebook groups. You'll see me pop in and out there. But KG6HQD is my handle on all my different platforms, and I hope to link up with you and on digital soon. So find me on digital. And by the way, that Santiago P, KJ6GRS, that is the machine that I tend to have one side of my radio on a regular basis in just a local mode. So if you link it from your side, feel free to hammer down and give me a call. You know, I'm kind of nicknaming DStar DeadStar right now just because I'm not hearing a lot of activity. So I hope that changes. I hope I'm wrong, but let's prove me wrong. Let's put some activity on there just like you saw the other side of my radio on Simplex. Let's use these frequencies up. So don't be shy. Key down, make a QSO. Nothing's going to happen. We'll just get to chat about something, and it'll be fun. So 73, have a good day, and we'll see you on the next video.